the backup, don't go, just the backup, just wait. That's the song I want us to sing as we are closing this service. The backup can stay, our own instrumentalists can play, because it's a very simple song. We want to thank the Lord for this service. It's a step of faith. And you can imagine, for the past 7 solid hours, what have we been doing? You didn't tell me, what have you been doing? Just worshiping. And the door of God's goodness is open to you. Can I have a louder amen? Please, I want all ministers that are here to please come and join me. This is the practice. The last few things we want to do, I want us to operate on what I call collective anointing. If you know you are a minister, please come and join me in here. I know some of us come with our children. If we have children here who are ages 2 to 10 and they don't have Bibles, and you want Bibles for them, let bring them to the front. If you have children, maybe you are able to bring your child, but it must be between ages 2 and what? And 10. Wonderful, marvelous are the works of my Lord. Great is thy name. Wonderful. You can give your children. And when they are not, let them go. Rest on your feet and wave your hands and sing with me. Wonderful, marvelous, and the works of my Lord. This morning, you are going back home with the presents. Please, if you can, let those people shift a little bit. Well, I still need this front here. I thought you would love. You are done with the children, Abi. If the Bibles are exhausted, please, you can have. I will make a promise that you write your names down, those students down, and I will make effort to carry to them. Please leave them, please. But you can write their names, let them go to the side and write the name of the children down, and probably the addresses. I will see what we can do about that. Now, please, as we close the service, I want to appreciate your presence attending JW7. I want to thank the Lord for all those whom the Lord has used to make this gathering a reality. Some by supporting with finance. Some really supported with their own presence, their talents, their connections. Some have been here since our 2 days, ensuring that this place is prepared. I may not be able to personally appreciate you, but heaven will reward you. I didn't hear your amen. For whatever you have contributed to make this worship session a reality, heaven will bless you. As we close the service, let me announce this. If the Lord tarries in his coming, November 22nd, 2019, JWH, we're still holding this place. You know, the number 8, 7 means perfection, Abi. Who knows the meaning of 8? What does 8 stand for? A new what? And that's what it means. And you will see a new beginning. But as we close the service, 3 categories of people the Lord say we should pray with, and that's why I invited our ministers to please join me. Number 1, we have worshiped for 7 hours. And when we get to heaven, we do nothing but what? Just worship. That's our duty in heaven. But that will only be for those who have genuinely turned their lives over to who? To Jesus. Peradventure, you have been worshiping with us for the past 7 hours, and you know you are not born again. I don't want you to go back home without giving your life to Jesus Christ. Like I said in the write-up, if you are able to get a booklet, your worship is empty when you don't have Jesus. I'll be glad if you can walk your way forward, and we are going to pray with you. Second category of people. You've been here tonight. You've given your life to Jesus Christ, but you know the life you are living does not reflect somebody who belongs to Jesus. I want to say, Jesus, enough is enough. I want to display that I belong to you. You also can walk to the front, and then we are going to pray with you. And the third category, that is a big load, a heavy load, that you left at home before you came here. It's been burdening your life, your heart. And you are saying, I've been worshiping the Lord. I don't want to go back home with that. I want to drop it at the feet of the Master. You also can find your way forward. As we sing the song, I Surrender All. And after that, we're going to pray with you. And I know the Lord will hear you. By this time next year, you will have a great testimony. So as you sing the song, I Surrender All, if you belong to any of those 3 categories, at this last minute of this worship, find your way to the front, and we shall pray together. Unto Jesus. Jesus. Oh, morning. I give my life to you. I surrender it all to you. Take over my life and help me to live for you. Holy Spirit, take over my life. Make me a new person. Jesus, cleanse me of my sins and let my name be written in the book of life. You are now my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. In Jesus' name, I pray. Dr. Jawadi, please, you pray with all of them.
Our Father, we thank you for this wonderful day, this hour of worship, hour that you are doing miracles, miracles of salvation, miracles of healing, miracles of restoration. Our God and our Father, we are grateful. Accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. For these your children, because they have worshipped you, you have drawn them unto you. I ask eternal Father that your glory will saturate them. You will permeate their life with your Holy Spirit. And I declare that as from today, their life shall be for your glory and for your power and for your strength in the name of Jesus. I declare that as from today, you will be an emblem of his glory and his power in the name of Jesus. I ask, Father, that you will write their names in the book of life. Those who have rededicated their life unto you, Father, we pray that your spirit will continue to lead them. They will not falter. They will not fumble. They will not fail you. And I pray when the trumpet shall sound, all of us shall be raptured. Thank you, eternal Father. Spirit of the living God, we pray that you will continue to minister to these ones. Those who have some burdens that they have brought here because they are in your presence, Lord, I pray that they will not go back with that burden. Jehovah God, you will turn things around for them. I pray that there shall be testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, gracious Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray.
This before we say the benediction, you can rise on your feet, but stay where you are. If there's any of you here standing in the front here who doesn't have a Bible personally, please allow them to enter this. You know you don't have Bible personally and you are in the front here, please come in. No more than those, and don't, please make sure they don't go beyond. Go beyond that, but I want them to be keyed in. They will be the first to get the Bibles. Others may get if we have ever have left. God bless you. So please, the security men, when they are done, you stop it. Some are just coming now. Watch it and make sure you secure it. Let everybody rise, please. Please let the minister stretch your hands towards them and bless them. I call it the Aaronic blessing, the blessings of the house of Aaron. Pray that these ones will come to JW8 with greater testimony. No one will come this year who will remain on the same spot next year. I see no one who has come here who will remain on the same spot in the name of Jesus. As the Lord liveth, you are not permitted to remain on the same spot. No matter what level you are in your office, by fire, you are being promoted. Whatever means you are being promoted, heaven is lifting you high, and Jehovah is being exalted. Because you choose to come to worship, the blessings of worship, you are taking back home. And all those who have supported one way or the other, no one will lose his reward. Thank you, Mary Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's say the grace together, please. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the blessings of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Shout hallelujah! Shout hallelujah! Shout hallelujah!
bless you. See you at JWH 22nd of November next year. I come with somebody. God bless you, Sir Samas. Please, the guest ministers, the artists.